and you can see the view from our door here. This is what you see when you enter our home. I gave a tour of our entryway, living room, and dining room. You can watch those videos. And then to the left, there's the stairs going up, and then the guest room through those double doors. Okay, so I always liked where the guest room is located because they can go from straight from the front door to the room. Then from the kitchen, family room, this is the way to it. It's the first doors on the right, and then the bathroom is over there, and it's actually an ensuite bathroom. You can see the door here. Okay, so when we have guests, we close the door to the hallway and they can just leave this door open. So it's a queen size bed, and I got those linens from West Elm. I think it was the something sale, I think Labor Day sale. I do have to get them pressed, but for now, that's what it is. Got this rug from Ross, and then when there was a flood in our house several years ago, we had the tiles redone here. And those are tiles. And then here to the right, we have the little frame that has the Wi-Fi information. And it just says, welcome. And then, you know, Wi-Fi and stuff. And then got a couple hooks here if they have keys for their cars. And I am planning to get a desk here. There's a desk that I like, but it's the same desk that I got from my husband that's in the family room. So I'm trying to find one in the right price point, with the right price point, mid-century modern that matches that chair. So maybe like a walnut color. And this is one of the six dining chairs that I have for the kitchen. I have a bench at the kitchen table. I only use four chairs. So one is here and one is for my husband's desk. I've had these tables forever. I think I got them at the room store. And these lamps are from, I believe, Lowe's. This is one of my favorite paintings, A Day on Sunday Afternoon in the Park by George Surratt. And I've just had that forever. I do plan to get a headboard. Okay, so as far as the headboard, I'm thinking upholstered, and then it would go high. And however high it is, then I will move that up above, or I can always move it. Not sure if I necessarily want a painting above the bed, just not sure. I mean, I could always put it over there, but for now, I think that would look nice. I think if the what do you think? If the headboard was high, and then, you know, it can only go so many feet, because I don't want the painting to go all touching the ceiling or whatever. Okay, so let me know in the comments below what type of headboard, or if you have a link, or, you know, message me on Instagram with a link, that'd be great. This I got from, I think Amazon, and then you've got the two pillows behind, and I just decided to have everything matching as far as, like a matching lamps and matching side tables. Okay, I gotta fix that later. It's a little bit slanted. Okay. And then up here, I have probably gone through three or four plants, even the pathos plants. And so I just decided to get one that, a fake one, a not real one. And I was into the boho before, so it's just kind of still saying boho. I still am into boho. Okay, and then these are the windows that go to the side of our yard. And then the neighbor is just right here. I believe this is her kitchen. But she's, I mean, it's only one person. She's a wonderful neighbor, quiet. So that works for us. Then we have a TV here. I used to have an Apple TV. I think I'm gonna put an old one here again. I'm not sure. There's the remote control. And so what I've done is, you know, when you're in a hotel room, what do you want? So we can, of course, have two people here because it's a queen bed. So I thought a TV, and then we have this little Nespresso machine that's just for espresso. And we have the little espresso mugs, some hot tea here, tea bags. And then inside I could put more stuff. Like sometimes I'll put like candy and nuts and stuff like that on here, in here. You got a couple coasters. So, and then here's another tray where They could put jewelry, watches, whatever. And then this is a bowl that I just put fresh fruit when people are here, like a couple bananas, apples, oranges. And then this milk glass holds the pods for the Nespresso machine. And I just make sure that the water is filled in the back when guests are here. Also, when you're in a hotel room, you like to have a microwave. Of course, they have full access to our kitchen and we serve them dinner and breakfast and stuff like that. But sometimes late at night, you don't want to bother going into the kitchen or, you know, just kind of want to stay in your room. So I have a microwave here. Okay, and then let's finish up here. Also for this cubby, these cubbies, I got these baskets from IKEA. I just thought they're cute. They're kind of wood and very sturdy. So they could put shoes here, whatever they want to put here. Extra bags, you know. These I got from, what are these? Yeah, Asiana Airlines. And you know, they're just like amenity kits. I think they're slippers. Yeah, they're slippers, okay. And then of course, in your hotel room, you have, at Chez Cheri, you have your little refrigerator. And the one that was here before, it was a one door. And I gave it to, forgot who I gave it to, but anyway, it got moved. And so I was searching and searching, and I had a problem with the freezer because I'm like, should I get one with the freezer or not? Because it really is so small. Well, I saw this on Amazon where it's a two-door mini fridge. Great reviews. So it keeps the frozen stuff frozen, right? Versus that one where it has just that thin door and it's one big door. So this has been great. I have a couple things of ice or three things of ice there. It did come with this ice tray, but I had two extras, so I just put that in there. And then the bottom one, I keep a couple of bottles of water, make sure when my guests are coming, I have that. Then they have space to put any leftovers that they want to have. And then I put some drinks here. Okay. Example, like sparkling water, Fresca lemonade. I think this is pink lemonade, you know. Yeah. All right, so this is the door to the bathroom. Okay. I want to show you that because I'll show you that in a different video. And then I just have hooks here where they can hang their towels or whatever, their jackets, whatever they want to put. And then I have a full length mirror here, which is enough space. If you back up here, it's good enough. Okay. And then I have these plugs, and it's actually a nightlight also. So when it gets dark, the light turns on. I got one there. All right. And then I have one there. And you can see the view from our door here. Onto the closet. So this side is for my guests, okay? The other side is water storage. I won't show you that because I'll show you that in another video. But I have the ironing board and the iron. Now, I have two irons because one of them, my son moved, and so I just took his iron from his apartment when he was in college, okay? And then this is the bath rug that when guests are here, I'll put it out into the bathroom, but I just store it here versus with the other linens or something like that. And then we just have some open hangers for pants, regular ones, and then ones you can also clip stuff onto. And we have this luggage rack, which I just absolutely think is such a nice touch for your guest room because they will bring luggage, even if it's a duffel bag or a backpack, whatever it is. They can lay it on there. It's off the floor, so there's space. And then I have this bin that's supposed to be a hamper. I didn't want like a full-size basket or a full-size hamper because most of the time my guests are not here longer than 3 days. So this was, I think, sufficient. And then behind the hamper, I do have this keyboard. It's my son's keyboard that I'm keeping for now. He likes to play with it when he does visit. So that's there until we're ready to let it go. Okay, let me show you that now. So you can open the door, and that's the bathroom. And then the shower tub is here. All right, that's a quick tour of our guest room. I hope you enjoyed. Click for more organizing videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.